Hello and welcome to 258webdesign.com. I'm Paul Bastante and thanks for checking out our video. We're glad to have you, and this video, it deals with a topic that's appropriate for today, Father's Day 2017. And the question we're attempting to answer is what it means to you to be a dad. Now listen, the word father and the word dad, the two are not mutually exclusive. You can be a father biologically and not be in your child's life, sadly, and that doesn't make you a good dad. The word dad, however, is a connotation that's completely different. And I've asked the seven different dads from around our community to talk to us about what it means to be a dad, what their favorite moments about being a dad is, and maybe the biggest piece of advice they would give to somebody who's thinking of becoming a dad for the very first time. So thanks a lot for being with us, and I hope you enjoy the video. Thanks.
Hi, I'm Anthony Zizzo, Zizzo's Auto Service. I have one son, his name is Anthony, and I just want to say Happy Father's Day.
How old is he?
He is four.
4 years old.
Yes.
I have four children, two boys, two girls. The oldest is my daughter Danielle, who just turned 24, followed by my son Steven, who just turned 23, Ryan, who turns 22 on Wednesday, and then my youngest is Nicole, who will turn 21 in October.
I'm Greg Tuck, and I am a dad to three kids, Julia, who's 15, Olivia is 13, and Jordy is 12.
Hey, I'm John Dunleavy. Happy Father's Day to everybody. I have four kids. Katie's my oldest. She's 25 years old. Then Ryan, he's 23. Emily, who is 20, and my youngest is Sean, who's 16.
How you doing, guys? My name is Mo from Pizza One. I have a beautiful daughter. Her name is Arya Ismail, and she is 1 year old.
Hi, I'm Adam Calese. I've got two children, 17-year-old senior Cassandra and 15-year-old freshman Alexander.
Okay, so I'm at Pizza One. I'm with Dante. Hi, Dante. How are you today?
Good, how you doing?
I'm doing okay, and it's Father's Day today, and I wanted to just get your ear because, you know, I actually respect you as a father. I've actually seen you with your kids. You have two young ones, a boy and a girl. What's your favorite thing about being a dad?
Really, the favorite thing about being a dad is no matter how bad your day is going, your ovens break, something goes wrong, employees didn't show up, no matter how bad the day is, once you get home and you open the door and the kids see you and they say, Daddy, 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 you forget about all your problems. Everything is to an end. You get so happy, your heart melts.
Favorite part of being a dad, living their lives through their eyes, seeing them experience things for the first time, seeing them the first time. Yeah, the walking and the talking and stuff is great, but when they take up the first day of school, their first day of trying a new sport, their first day of getting involved in an activity, the first time of seeing things, seeing the joy and the excitement, the fact that, you know, I'm much older now, I'm more jaded, but to see them and enjoy for the first time, I guess enjoy all over again.
You know, there's just not one answer to that question. I have so many favorite parts, but probably. It's just having four best friends, you know, four of my children that I'm very close with, that I love more than anything in this world. But it's just having them in my life. And the fact that I have the responsibility to guide them, raise them, and they're going to learn from my wisdom and my actions, and I take that responsibility seriously. So it's just having them in my life and considering them all my best friends.
My favorite part of being a dad is has been able to watch them grow and nurture and to see that they're listening to the things that we've been teaching them all these years, and now I'm getting to the stage where they're having to enter the workforce, they're graduating college, and to see them really grow into an adult, and it's really nice to see, and it's really nice to have people come up to you. I think the ultimate compliment as a parent is when someone walks up to you and tells you how good your son or your daughter is and how polite they are when they're not with you.
My favorite part about being a dad is showing up to the house. You get home from work, you have a real long day, and that little guy's waiting at the door for you. Big smile on his face, dancing in the window, and makes everything. Any problems you had all day, it makes everything go away.
The best part of being a dad is after a long day of work,
you come home and she is so excited to see you and her face lights up, and that just melts my heart.
My favorite part about being a dad is really being able to see the world, which is in some ways very different to what it was 30 or 40 years ago, and in some ways it's exactly the same. Being able to see that world through totally different eyes. So I get to see the world through a 7-year-old girl sometimes, or a 12-year-old boy, and just see the challenges and excitement and victories and losses through those lives, and just being able to come alongside them and support them, cheer for them, root for them, console them sometimes. But seeing the world through their eyes is the best thing about being a dad.
You know, every family has a story about the birth of one of their children and perhaps what happened, and whether it be a special memory, a funny memory, a sad memory, whatever it may be. From your words, what's your favorite memory from the birth of one of your children?
I've got to be honest, I'm not very good at childbirth.
Okay.
So the main reason we only have 3 kids is because I can't do childbirth.
Because the year when she was born, came a little bit early, not too terribly early, but in the hospital room during delivery, she missed the word don't before push.
But the greatest memory, sincerely, is when Sean was born, my youngest, was the pure joy and love from my 3 oldest when he was born.
And it was my first one, my daughter Danielle, and they were having a hard time getting her to come out.
You know, you see on TV when kids are born, usually they cry and scream. You know, when my son came out, he's just like looking around.
And how they were just so ecstatic, and it was the purest form of love and joy that I've ever seen when they got to see the youngest brother.
With Julia, it was a 49-hour labor, and I had drunk gallons and gallons of coffee.
They prep my wife for a C-section. Before they do C-section, they'll use a suction cup to try and kind of pull the child out.
You know, they're cleaning him up and wiping him down, and he was like so nosy right off the bat. He's looking around, see what's going on, looking at the doctors.
So when the doctor said don't push, my wife heard push and popped her out.
And I remember right towards the end, I was right in Karen's face, saying. Like right in her face.
So now usually when you see on TV, right, they pick the baby up by the legs, upside down, and they slap the baby's ass and they make him cry. Like, they didn't want to do that?
Well, I told the doctor, if you try it out, I'm going to break your hands.
No, you didn't.
So that's my son.
No, we're not going to be slapping. The first memories you're going to have is not that.
Definitely not.
She came in the world literally being caught over the shoulder,
right,
like a football pass,
right,
by the doctor. So that's how she entered the world.
And eventually, I think she was tired of it. And during a contraction, she took it and just said, "You've got coffee breath." And so I backed up, and then somehow the next thing I knew, I was holding a baby. So she did it without me.
And as they were doing that, it made a sound kind of like that. And my wife picked up her head and said, was that the baby's head? Like, did it fall off? Yeah. And that whole place started to crack up, and it was just a really funny moment.
And just her face, how her reaction was of happiness. I'll never forget that ever again.
You know, you all have your favorite moments about maybe perhaps one of your children's births. Something funny that happened, or something interesting, or a memory that you had. If you could share one of your favorite memories about the birth of your son.
My favorite memory about the birth of my son is he took a hole in my heart and filled it back up. My dad passed away about 2 months before my son came. Huh? My son came in and he took almost all that pain away.
I have kids, I have 3 of them. My youngest one's 9, my oldest one's 17. 19 years ago when I got married and I was thinking about becoming a dad for the first time, I have to be honest, there's a million things that went through my mind. Some bordering on, you know, absolute insanity. You know, am I going to survive this if I do it? To moments of just sheer wanting to be a dad, right? So, and everything in between. So if you could give some advice to somebody today, Father's Day 2017, who's sitting in their house, maybe they're on their fishing boat, and they can still fish, right? Because, you know, they don't have kids yet. So maybe they're on their boat and they're thinking, what would be the biggest piece of advice you would give them about potentially becoming a dad?
Again, there's not just one bit of advice you can give a future dad, but being that I love fatherhood, my advice would be, know that you're ready to become a dad. That's most important.
My best advice for someone becoming a father for the first time, patience. You're going to need it because you're going to have less time to do the things that you like to do.
Wow. Trying to come up with advice for a person who's going to be a father is really, really difficult. A few superficial things. Sleep in when you can, now.
Patience. I know people that had multiple years of trying and couldn't conceive, took a long time, or some had it the first time, but enjoy the time together with your wife before it happens.
It's a lifetime job. So to any new dad, you need to really know that it's the time of your life that you want to do it, because you have the most important job for the next 40 years or more.
And you now have to kind of sacrifice your time for that other being in your life.
Enjoy what you can do right now, being either with your wife.
You're never really ready for it. You might think you are. You can read all the books you want, and that baby pops out, all the rules have been changed.
Going out to dinner, taking little naps. Enjoy your sleep. The sleep is gone. Buy yourself a nice shirt occasionally. Watch a movie. Go out to dinner, quiet dinner with your wife.
Don't do it.
No, it's not don't do it. No, it's not don't do it.
It's really, having kids is the best blessing in the world.
I guess a good way to analogize it is to remember that a dad's job is, you're not the anchor to keep your kids down. You're not the sail to bring them a place. You're the guiding light to make sure they get there successfully.
You're never going to be 100% ready. Don't wait too long.
Just so my advice to anybody who's becoming a dad is really be a role model for your kids. You know, everything you do is going to impact them.
But even just the little stuff, because it's not just so simple to go out to dinner anymore. You know, so you take that for granted. My advice would be to see this as a lifetime commitment. That you're in this for the long haul, and there'll be ups and downs, but this is what life's about.
Be patient, be open, be willing to listen.
The way you act toward your wife, the way you act toward people, kindness, and all right. Hardworking. So your kids are gonna look up to you. You are their role model.
I'm 37 years old now. My son's 4. I wish I would have done it a little bit earlier, so I had a little bit more youth left in me to keep kicking around with him.
So what you're saying is being a dad doesn't come without its physical challenges.
Of course not.
So you want to be on your best behavior all the time in front of your kids so they can turn out to be somebody like you.
It really is the crux of this entire thing for Father's Day. So what does it mean to you to be a dad? Now, before you answer, some people think that being a father, right, and being a dad are mutually exclusive, but I don't feel that they are mutually exclusive. I think that there's people who are, especially on a day like today, that don't have any connections with their kids, right? They don't see their kids for whatever reason, and that's really sad. They're actually still fathers, but they're not dads. So what does it mean to you to be a dad?
To me, is to be there for your kids. Growing up with them, experience everything with them, raising them, and just being part of their life and growing with them. That's the way I feel.
Everything.
Be a dad gives me a chance to pass on what I learned from my father.
Words have meanings, right? And when you talk about father as a word,
right,
and you talk about dad as a word, right, they have perhaps two different meanings, sometimes the same meaning, but the two definitely aren't mutually exclusive. So what does it mean to you to be a dad?
What does it mean to be a dad to me? Well, I'll go back to my days as a juvenile corrections officer when I dealt with juveniles. And the one thing that always came to mind is that you can't pick your parents or your father or your dad. You're kind of born into that. And what I mean by that is that sometimes it's not the best situation. And the name father or dad is that, it's a name. I've helped many children out over the years that are not my children. And we've had that father and son, dad and boy, or dad and daughter relationship. And it's about giving of yourself to another to try and make a better life for them and to help them through those hard times. Being an adolescent is a very tough thing in the United States these days, with a lot of things pulling you from side to side. And it's not necessarily a good area you end up in. So if I can help myself, my children, and or their friends or close relative's child to succeed in the world, I think that's what being a dad is about, is helping and helping them succeed.
And that's beautiful.
There's no better feeling in the world than that little guy looking up to you and just waiting for your next move and watching every move you make. And I just want to pass everything I have and give it to him. All the knowledge I have, everything. I would do anything for him. And
yeah,
that's it. That feeling of that little guy staring up at you, and it does everything for you.
So being a dad is a chance to kind of spread the idea of respect and being kind and getting along with people and doing the right thing and having a good influence, a positive influence.
So now we get to what the crux of this video is about. And really, when I set out to do it, this is the question that I wanted to answer. And I wanted certain people to answer it for us. Okay, so the question to you, what does it mean to you to be a dad?
Yeah, my favorite Bible verse is from Psalm 84, and it said, "Blessed is the man whose heart is set on pilgrimage." And that's my life verse, and really that translates to being with my kids, where this is a pilgrimage that we're on. It starts in different ways, maybe, like in our family, but it's a pilgrimage. It's a journey that sometimes has detours, sometimes has valleys and mountaintops, but just experiencing that journey with the kids every day in different ways. And that's what life's about for me, is with my wife, just walking this journey, this pilgrimage with them, seeing the world through their eyes, helping them be a blessing and helping them find their own blessing.
Being a dad is the idea of just passing along the fact that, again, respect each other, get along, and everything will be a little better.
Okay, because this video, this is what it's about. It's about the concept of, you know, the word father and the word dad, and the fact that maybe the two are not mutually exclusive, and you know, and so we're concentrating on the dad, not the father, and what it means to be a dad. So we really want to know what it means to you specifically to be a dad.
Again, you know, for me to be a dad is one of the most proudest moments of my life. To this day, continue raising my children. Obviously, next to marrying my wife, it is one of my best accomplishments ever. And to me, it means a great responsibility. I feel that a dad can give his children two of the greatest gifts in life. And one is to guide them, to listen to them, but most importantly, to believe in them. To me, that is the most important thing you can do as a dad, is believe in your children. And the second thing, the greatest gift that a dad can give his children, is to love their mother. Kind of where I'm at.
They say happy wife is happy life, right? Happy mom is happy, you know, that's happy life, okay, while we're talking about it.
Having kids is the best blessing in the world.
To all those dads out there, all those fathers-to-be, it's your day. Kick back, relax, put your feet up, make sure the kids wait on your hand and foot, with a smile on your face, and enjoy your day.
We just want to say happy Father's Day to everyone out there, and special happy Father's Day to the big guy up in heaven. We miss you, man.
I always remember that it takes a village to raise a child, and that's very true, and we both live that in both our towns.
Yep.
Hey, fathers, dads, have a great, great Father's Day.
Just want to say happy Father's Day to all the fathers out there. I'm sure all your work is appreciated by everyone. So happy Father's Day.
For me, to your family, wishing everybody, all the guys out there, happy Father's Day.
father, right? The word father and the word dad. You know, father tends to insinuate a biological relationship, whereas a dad, it's not necessarily the case. And so to be a dad in that respect, explain to us what that's like, because that's something that it's special.
Yeah, it really is special. Just to consider a physical childbirth, which is pretty a miraculous thing in itself. But even with adopting Jordy, it was like a long, protracted labor with the pains and the excitement that go along with it. And of course, just arriving almost exactly 3 years ago to the day with Jordy at JFK was just like the final childbirth, and then just raising him. Obviously, he's my son. But the big point here really is that it's easy to be a biological progenitor. And two of my kids have my DNA in them, and one has no DNA. And but the difference between being having DNA and being a physical father who's provided that DNA, and being a dad who is really involved in their lives and cares and mentoring and dreaming with them, consoling and celebrating and cheering, and just living life with them every day, that's a huge difference. The first one is easy, anyone can do it. But the second one is really where the joy is, and really where I find a lot of my meaning is just in walking this journey with these three kids, no matter where they come from, whether they put me through physical childbirth or not. I just love being a dad. And when I feel alone, when I think I can't go on, I hear him saying, son, you've been